Hi, I'm Jacob. I'm the F&B director here at the Siam Kempinski Hotel in Bangkok. And I'm reaching out to you from this wonderful garden, an urban oasis in the middle of the city. And urban oasis is the right word because we're going to do two Mediterranean-inspired drinks. First one is a green tea, iced green tea, but it's basically a cold brew Moroccan iced tea. So we're starting with an iced Moroccan-inspired green tea. Then we have some fresh mint. We're gonna add it into the tea, half a lemon and some honey. We have in here the green tea. I start brewing it basically 15 hours ago. Very simple, use regular green tea, the one that you have at home. Not a jasmine, not recommended, just really a plain green tea. What you need, of course, even though it's a cold brew tea, you add some additional ice, so it really wakes you up. So we put plenty of ice, a good amount of mint, perfect, honey, and finally we're gonna squeeze half a lemon just to add a bit of sourness to it as well, and as I said before, a great liver cleanser. Once we have all the ingredients in the jar, stir it. What is important is you need to really stir the mint nicely, soft, don't stir it too hard. You don't want to create bitterness. You just pour from the jar directly into these wonderful cups. And grab some mint. Looks great, especially when you have guests at home. You want to give them something refreshing, a wonderful drink to serve. There we go. Looks beautiful, tastes fantastic. We're doing the next drink now. It's basically a vegan Greek frappe. Why is it vegan? We're using almond milk and dairy-free chocolate. And so Greek frappe, first of all, why are we doing this? I've been to Greece a few years ago and in the summertime and had basically every day, I would say, at least 4 to 6 Greek frappes. Super popular in Greece throughout the entire day. So what we have here is basically we have cardamom powder, cinnamon powder. We have the cafe itself, so it's ground cafe, grounded cafe, bit of salt and brown sugar and the chocolate over here. I'm gonna show you the steps now. I'm using now 3.5 spoons of cafe, and basically you can use any ground cafe. What I'm doing different is, as I said, I'm adding a little bit of cardamom. So basically just a few drops of cardamom, because cardamom is very, very strong in flavor. Same for cinnamon, just a few drops, a little bit more than the cardamom. And then, unusual, I like to add a little bit of salt, gives a bit of a salty flavor, almost like a salty caramel flavor. And sugar is very much needed, because you would need to get the creaminess, and that's what you're gonna get from the sugar. So what we're gonna do right now is add some water, hot water, and I'm adding right now approximately 20 milliliters. That's the maximum, because if you use too much water, it will take you very long to get a foam, if you get any foam at all. So I'm doing the manual way, but of course maybe you're more advanced at home and you have an electric mixer, so feel free to use it. Throughout the process, you will see the color is changing from dark coffee to a very nice light brown. So we are halfway through right now. Whew. It's like magic. As long as you mix it, as more thick it gets. So it's totally up to you how thick you want it. I want it that thick that I can use an ice scooper to pour it on top of the milk, so it's gonna look great and very appealing, especially if you invite friends and family members to have it with you. Here we go, that's basically how you would like to have it. So once you have the creamer set, Take your glass, fill it with ice. So glass is full with ice. Take your almond milk, 3/4 of the glass, fill it with almond milk. You have the wonderful coffee foam. And as I said, I'm using the scooper. Just as you can see, especially if you have friends, family at home and you do it in front of them, I'm sure they're gonna love it. The great part about this frappé is it doesn't just look amazing, it tastes wonderful. Here we go. And of course we eat also with our ice, and we want to make it look absolutely stunning. We add this vegan dark chocolate on top, and it's totally up to you as how much you want to add on top. Here we go, our vegan Greek frappé. Cheers.